advanced pharmacology. Advanced pharmacology. Okay. Now, what advanced pharmacology? What are the things we have to study in advanced pharmacology? The first of all thing is the side effect drug interaction and the contraindication is more important in advanced pharmacology than only knowing the mechanism of action and the pharmacological action. Okay. For NIPER, like for anti-cancer, as you know, the common side effect is severe vomiting, emesis, and as well as alopecia, okay, bone marrow suppression. So these are some common side effects. But for NIPER, they would like to more concentrate on specific side effects. Okay, like for example, if you talk about antiviral. So anti-cancer, what are the things I have taught in the Growell class? That you please refer. But antiviral, I would like to draw an attention, especially the drug acting on HIV, influenza, okay, influenza, and as well as your hepatitis B. These are the all different, of course, COVID-19, it's a new one, but still, I'll providing you a review article of mine on COVID-19, so that will help you to understand more. But remaining that this, you know, this kind of virus is more, you know, more important. Like if I ask that some antiviral agent used to treat cytomegalovirus infection, and it is antisense therapy. Okay. So now antisense therapy is something which is like advanced. So NIPER sometimes ask some advanced drugs or recent US FDA approved drugs. So antisense therapy for to treat cytomegalovirus is Fomivirsen. Okay, so these are the things we have to remember for NIPER, and the different types of the classification which is related to antiviral and even anti-cancer, like CCR5 inhibitors. Okay, this I have all discussed in my Growell classes. Then they may ask you lot of monoclonal antibody. Like whenever you are talking about anti-cancer, it is monoclonal antibody. Now even in virus also, like in COVID-19, they are try to find out the monoclonal antibody against ACE2 receptor. That is very important, ACE2 receptor. I will provide my review article on it, so you can read from there. Now hepatitis B, what is the drug used in hepatitis B? That is lamivudine. So these are the important informations is very important as per NIPER is concerned. Now then coming to the next antiviral, you go to the third quadrant, which is I have already taken the video, beta-lactam, then tetracycline, then linezolid, and as well as your aminoglycosides. These are the things are very important. Okay, you please read out from our Google video class. The next thing is in advanced pharmacology, the next topics that we must study, antifungal agents. Now, as I have told you, the side effects. Now, for example, you have ketoconazole. Now, ketoconazole, the side effect, everybody knows, if you give it orally, it causes the liver dysfunction. Okay, but now, apart from the liver dysfunction, it also suppresses the activity of androgen. So, loss of libido can be a side effect of for ketoconazole therapy. The next is your voriconazole. Voriconazole side effect is prolonged QT intervals. So those things, and then when this drug should not be given in combination with which drugs, that we have to also remember. We only remember that the individual side effect, and then we have to see that if the two side effects are common, so that means those drugs cannot be given together. Okay. Then you have brand name like Tamiflu. it's an antiviral agent, okay, oseltamivir. So the brand names are also very important, but it is found that, you know, they found that the virus is giving some sort of resistance towards the oseltamivir therapy. Then you must find it out that what are the new the drugs available for, you know, to counteract the flu virus. Okay, then coming to the next part is your morphines. Your morphines, morphine side effects, and how morphine side effects is connected to ANS. Okay, then you have CVS. Now remember, whenever I'm talking about CVS, it is not only drug acting on the cardio, it is also acting on kidney, drug acting on kidney, lungs. So that means, of course, the GIT. That means your drug acting on heart, like your antiarrhythmic agent, blood pressure, antihypertensive agent, anti-angina, ischemic heart disease, myocardial infarction, congestive heart failure, everything come on the cardio. When it is kidney, it is diuretics. Now diuretics also part of an hypertension, but it is specifically act on kidney. Then you have lungs, bronchodilators, okay. Then mucolytics. In NIPAR they ask a lot of questions, you know, some, because these lungs and GIT very few people study, and that's why, you know, the things which very less important for the students, and that is more important for the NIPAR people to give, you know, on the paper. Okay, then GIT, you know, some prokinetic drugs, anti-emetic drugs, their site of action, their mechanism of action, and you know, like sizapride, okay, it is an anti-emetic drug. Why it should not be given with other drugs, and which drug can combine with sizapride to increase the cardiac side effect. So those things are very important to understand. Now coming to after that, you have CNS acting drug. CNS acting drug, the side effect and the mechanism of action is pretty easier than the all other, you know, the topics, because it is either counteracting like Parkinson and psychosis, they are almost opposite. Okay, then you come to the depressions. Okay, then you come to the, you know, the Parkinson, the your Alzheimer's, those other diseases.